thank you for holding the hearing today on the grid-scale energy storage. I'd like to welcome our witnesses and thank you all for joining us to talk about how storage technologies can help us address some of our greatest challenges, like climate change and energy cost. But before we jump in, I'd like to acknowledge that one of our witnesses, Andy Ott. Andy has recently announced that he will be retiring at the end of the month after a successful 22, is that correct, Andy? 22-year tenure running the largest grid in North America with the PJM. Andy, I want to thank you again for being here today, but thank you for your service all these years, and we wish you nothing but the best in the future. Grid-scale energy storage is a hot topic these days and for good reason. Energy storage is needed to achieve the full potential of renewable energy. It's really a key enabling technology to a low-carbon modern grid that will help us achieve our carbon emissions reductions and address climate change. Storage allows us to dispatch energy during times of peak demand, enhance the reliability of our grid, provide energy security and backup power for customers, and enable increased flexibility for helping to manage the continued growth of renewable generation on our system. Storage can also help defer distribution system upgrades, and it can be installed quickly compared to traditional generation, bringing better value to customers while maintaining reliability. Several members of this committee have introduced bills to advance storage this Congress. The administration proposed an increase in energy storage R&D and a new cross-cutting initiative to address the remaining barriers. Furthermore, FERC has been working to make sure owners and operators of storage resources have fair and equal access to competitive wholesale energy markets. Meanwhile, system operators, utilities, and generators are working out the details in the energy markets. With all this activity, I'd say this hearing is going to be very timely. I look forward to hearing from the panel about how to prioritize taxpayer dollars to create the most value for energy storage, both now and in the future. I don't think anyone here will disagree that more work needs to be done to advance storage technology or bolster existing technologies like lithium-ion batteries, which is currently our best bet for chemistry batteries. In an editorial just published May 14th, Bill Gates has stressed the importance of energy storage as one of the three key technology suites we should be pursuing in addition to advanced nuclear and carbon capture and better transmission lines. While battery technology has a long way to go, costs are coming down. In 2010, the cost of lithium-ion batteries was about $1,000 per kilowatt hour. Now we're down to about $200 per kilowatt hour, which is great progress, but it's not enough. There are problems with lithium-ion. I understand that we may not be able to get the cost down to much below $100 per kilowatt hour. Also, we have only one active lithium operation in the U.S. and are otherwise dependent on foreign countries to supply this critical material, which is why I'm the lead Democrat on Senator Murkowski's American Mineral Securities Act, as well as the sponsor of the Rare Earth Elements Advanced Coal Technology Act, which highlights the work that WVU and NETL are doing to extract these materials from coal byproducts. So while we discuss the advancement of storage technologies here today, I want to remind my colleagues of the importance of the supply chain of materials needed to actually manufacture energy storage resources. Furthermore, energy storage won't be one size fits all. We need several different types of storage technologies available to us so we can find the right tool for the job to store energy for later use. So I look forward to a robust discussion on what policies we need to get a suite of storage technologies ready to go and to the point of being cost effective. We also need your help to see around the next corner to make sure we're preparing our energy grid to handle the energy demands of the future, while also preparing our economy and our workforce to be competitive and robust in a global market. I don't think anyone here will disagree that more work needs to be done to advance storage technology to bolster existing technologies like lithium-ion batteries. We have only one in the U.S. I also briefly mentioned one type of storage that might not be as flashy and new as some of the other emerging technology, but it's critical nonetheless. Pump storage represents 95%, and I repeat, 95% of installed storage capacity in the U.S. today. It's renewable, zero carbon, and tried and true. I'd like to see more pump storage deployment in states like West Virginia. Here we have the needed topography and water. I know that Brookfield already operates the Hawk's Nest hydro facility in West Virginia and one of the largest pump storage hydro facilities in Massachusetts. I hope to hear about any pump storage development the panelists may have in works and how we in Congress can help advance those efforts. As I've said before, we need to be nurturing and advancing all technologies that can help us combat climate change. I want to say one thing off script. The chairman and I just came back from a trip to the Arctic. and we met with all the Arctic nations. And what I took away from that trip was this: not one, including Russia, has used climate change as a political divisiveness. They all know it's life or death up there for them to survive in that fragile ecosystem. It was unbelievable to walk away seeing everybody from the far right to the far left to anywhere in between trying to find an answer and how to subvert this, because it is real and it is damaging. It's going to affect all of our lives, and we have that responsibility. So it was an unbelievable trip that it was most educational for me and enlightening. So I look forward to working with my colleagues on the Energy Committee to explore how energy storage can be leveraged in conjunction with other grid assets to bring to bear the greatest benefits for the grid, its customers, and its environments. We have a lot to cover today, and I look forward to hearing from our panel. So I want to thank you, Madam Chairman, for this hearing.
Thank you.